Ja, hello everyone. Welcome back to Planet Coaster. Yes, it's the action coaster again. Last time we completed the complete front interior section of the supermarket, and today we're doing the backstage area. Not really the backstage area, but like the warehouse area where all the employees work. Yeah, what you see here is a lot of placement of boxes. And those are Team TK as well. Like, look at all these boxes. What was in the boxes, nobody will ever know. It's a big mystery. And I made a little queue. I decorated the queue section here to be all themed and stuff. Wow, such a high standard. Of this could be placed in Disney. Yep. Like, a supermarket coaster is like the greatest idea ever. Basically, Ratatouille, only in a supermarket instead of a restaurant or Paris. Anything outside of Paris is great, really. Just France is... Yeah, you know how it is. Yeah, more boxes. Oh, yep. I kind of forgot what I did this episode, but yeah, this is the second and final episode of the action coaster. Yeah, it's over already. Nice. Yeah, just a short thing. Yeah, I'm just clearing my PC in anticipation of the new PC. So that's basically what I'm doing. I finished Assassin's Creed Revelations, as you might have noticed on the channel. Nobody watches that, that's fine, but that was also on my PC for a long while, so that's also why I finished it. Just because I don't have to transfer any files to my new computer. Also, I remember, actually remember now, I have a Spore Let's Play I need to finish. I think I started that like over a year ago now. I have one episode left to do. I might as well just do it. Like, it doesn't mix any well with the new content on the channel. But who cares, you know? Just for those five people that have been waiting for that for a year, I can make a nice little surprise for them. Oh, yeah, I made like a freezing section here. I forgot to record it. I think I forgot to hit the button on my PC Crest or some stuff like that. Yeah, it's quite tedious. But yeah, it's there. The actions don't actually have a section like that, but again, it's just to incorporate all the Team TK stuff. It's more based on a real supermarket than a discount store. Yeah, I shouldn't be saying supermarket, actually. It's more, yeah, it's a discount store, like, or a drugstore, really. Finally, we're working on the front facade. Just making the windows now, which are really ugly. They have the they have the, just a blue wooden panel in front with the glass and then some advertisements on them. But I was too lazy to do all the advertisements on there, so it's just a blue panel. I mean, there's only so much effort I'm gonna put in this stupid build. It's so stupid. It's so stupid. Oh well, yeah. Covering the back end in brick now. Because, well, brick is a neutral color and mixes well. No, it's bullshit. No, it's just... I can't have the white thing going on here all the way. Some nice trimming on the building now to give it more detail. Detail? Where is that? I don't know. Yes. Super exciting things to watch, of course. I kind of lost my flow with the whole building things, guys. It's such, been a, such a long time. I need to get back in this game. Need to finish Blueport. Or at least continue with it. Actually, you should do that now, yeah. But yeah, a nice little overhang here over the entrance so people don't have to get wet when they're standing outside. Why would you stand outside? I don't know, but maybe if the store is closed, then you can stand outside and not be wet. Wow, what a revelation, what an invention. Yeah, for the roof panels I used the tar patch thing, I like that one. It's kind of annoying because you can see the creases in between the panels. That's kind of a downside to using those. But I tried to hide it all. So I use brick here to finish off the top part of the section. As you may notice, there's a lot of lights shining down into the story. Otherwise, it's so dark in there. I had to use a lot of lights. And there's also like floodlights underneath the whole store, like 20 meters in the ground to illuminate it even more. It's quite tricky to do, actually. But I didn't want to show you guys. There's just a lot of dark and footage you can't see properly. And there's some trimming around here, and it really starts to take shape now, doesn't it? What a beautiful project this is. Truly something I can be proud of. Yeah, wow. I get so excited to play the game now again. Well, this is just realistic. Yeah. That's something. Yeah. I need to get used to talking to myself again. It's weird. I can't wait to start streaming, guys. It's just like so much. Seems so much more fun to just talk with people while you're gaming. And then you can immediately incorporate you guys' feedback into the build. I mean, it may be a bit boring to watch because it's a very slow process. That's why I speed this up. But you know, if people are interested in it, I will be start streaming soon. When I have my new computer, so that's like June or August. No, I hope it will be sooner, but it's just nothing happening at the delivery thing. Ordered it at the end of October. It's the middle of January now when I'm recording this. And still nothing has happened. So, yeah, it's kind of annoying. Well, as I said in the last episode, everything came in except for the GPU. I got the 3080, which is a good card. But it's also a card that isn't in stock anywhere. And my brother actually built it. He bought the same setup. And he got lucky because he was 2 hours earlier with the buying of his CPU. And he got that over a month ago now. So a 2 hour difference in ordering a CPU can lead up to at least a month difference in delivery time. Which is kind of ridiculous and kind of annoying. And then he managed to snipe a 3080 as well. So he got lucky. He's already using it. Just tease me. Because I can't use mine. First world problems, is it though? Yeah. Anyway, nice pavement outside. Isn't it nice? It's probably the nicest looking thing of this build. And it just continues down the wall here. Then some gift cards and a balloon. You know, and a homeless person. The things you can expect is at an action here. Some newspapers, a lot of newspapers. They must have a lot of news in this little city here. Yeah, or a lot of people to buy them, but I don't see any. And there's some trash here, because trash in a trashy area is trash-nificant. Trash-nif, yeah. More beer crates. Wow. Really, isn't that exciting? The cinematic of the build, by the way, will be after the building section of in this video. I won't do a separate video because the build isn't worthy of a separate video. That's just so stupid. Now I'm just gonna incorporate this into the Planet Coaster Blueprints playlist as well, just to fill that up a bit. Oh, I forgot about Jollywood. I still have that going on as well. Yeah, there's a lot of projects I need to finish. Yeah, I must say, I've been having fun with doing some other stuff lately, like Assassin's Creed. But yeah, again, I'm just waiting for my new computer because I can't play the next installment. Because that's the remastered edition. I'm not gonna play the old version if I can play the new version. But yeah, I can't hit a steady 60 frames there, so that's kind of jarring for me. So I'm just, yeah, again, waiting on the computer. Also disabled the member function, the memberships function. Because no one was using it and felt a bit stupid to have it there. So it's just gone. Probably gonna focus a bit more on Twitch soon. Then I will try to edit down videos for YouTube as well. For people who don't like Twitch or whatever. Twitch is kind of a funny platform. It's very community based. And it has its positives and negatives. YouTube is a bit more corporate and it's more like a portfolio for me. Even though it's just Plenko, it does feel like you polish a build and you put it out there. And Twitch is a bit more raw and mistakes happen or like it can be boring or whatever. I need to get used to that. Also, you're always on the spot, you know, you can't edit out stupid things you say, which I do quite a lot. But yeah, that's going to be fun. I'm not sure what games I will play, but Planet Coaster will sure be one of the games I play. Maybe Planet Zoo, because I need to finish stuff in there. For sure Assassin's Creed, even though that's kind of unpopular, but well, I really like that, so yeah. And then I might just take a break of a week to play Red Dead Redemption 2. Because I've bought that 2 times now and I haven't played it yet because my PC can't handle it. And I didn't want to play it on PS4 in the end, so it's kind of stupid. But kind of fun as well. No, not really. It's just a waiting. Oh, some pigeons here. Who doesn't like pigeons? Yeah, yeah. This build is so stupid. If people vote for this in the competition thing, I'll be having a good laugh. Because the whole thing about this competition was, you need to build an action coaster, like an exploration coaster, super high speeds, motion, a movie-like experience with explosions and stuff. Yeah, stuff blowing up and trucks and trains and cars and people and blah blah blah. And I was like, no, I'm gonna build an action because it's the action coaster contest. That's what they're getting. But there's stuff happening in the supermarket. There's fire effects and rain, well, sprinklers. And that's about it. There's some mice moving. I think there's a monkey clapping its hands, being happy. And that's about it for the action on this coaster. But it's more of a, it's better as a still image, I would say. Just like Cyberpunk, because that game also is better as a still image. Our stuff starts moving, it starts falling apart. Okay, a little backstage area here. This is really the backstage area. I guess it's just a loading bay of the... Is that the right word? I don't know. More sidewalk. Wow. What am I placing on the sidewalk? I don't know. Oh, I put some Dixies. Is that the word you guys use as well? There's one. Like a portable toilet. Because that's what you need in a trashy area like this. So, yeah, what supermarket would you guys like to see next, guys? Maybe a Walmart or Target. Or CVS, is that a thing, right? Walgreens. Or Best Buy. That's really all stores I know in the States or Canada, whatever. Put some curbs on the side here. Did you know that the curbs only work on employees and not the guests? I thought they would work on both, but apparently they don't, so I need to replace a lot of those things in the parks I build in. This is kind of annoying. But oh well. Little camera there, little door. And the door is now smaller. Some poles. We still got like a minute left in this video. What is there more to do? I don't know. Yeah, thanks for bearing with me, guys, through this wonderful experience of building this wonderful supermarket with my lovely, exciting commentary. Yeah, I just want to put this out there, the supermarket thing. Lest we got this over with. Some safety markers, that's it. That's what we got left to do. Alright, yeah. Yeah, if you liked the video, subscribe, comment, tell me what you like and didn't like about the build. Make sure to keep a close eye on the channel, and because I might migrate to Twitch soon, start there. Oh, this is a little Easter egg, by the way. You'll see it in the cinematic after this. But yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. Enjoy the cinematic after this, and yeah. Oh, this isn't Blanco. Oh, yeah. You guys, nice dragon, right? Nice, this guy. Yeah. Okay, anyway. See you guys next time.